So I found a really interesting deal that lets you generate images with variables. Now, what does that mean? Well, let's just say I create an image with a template, and in that template, I have a person's name, their company's name, the URL, a date, or whatever type of information I want to change with variables. Well, it's gonna automatically do it with several type of automations. So I can use API, I can use Zapier, Integromat, via link, and several other features more. So let me show you what I'm talking about and actually what the deal is. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. Okay, so before we jump into the deal, I first want to show you what it actually does, and then I'll jump into how it actually works. So like I mentioned before, these variables can be changed via automation tools. So for example, each one of these variables corresponds to one of the elements on the right, and I could designate if I want to have it editable or not. So what does that mean? I can use Zapier with another type of automation, and when someone sends the information through Zapier, it's gonna automatically generate an image with their logo, with their name, with the role, with the date, and with their link. Or if I don't like those elements, I'll just change them. But it's going to do it automatically, and it's gonna generate an image, creating something unique and something that they might think you took several minutes or hours to generate, but actually it was done automatically. So let me show you what the actual deal is, and it's $79 for the lifetime deal. So that means you pay once and use it forever. If you guys want to grab that deal, there's an affiliate link in the description, which helps me out with a small commission to help me out to make these videos for you guys. So let me show you what that actually gets you. You get 2,000 monthly image generated per month. So that's a lot of images. Unless you plan on going really crazy generating images, that's practically enough for most people. You get unlimited image generation via form, unlimited templates, unlimited bandwidth, 30 minutes video generated per month. Now the video generation, it's really low, so that's not the main focus. And if you need more, you'd have to go into the monthly plan. So kind of, I would say that if you wanna use it for images, you're okay. But if you wanna use it for videos, 30 minutes, it's not a whole lot unless you're creating really short videos, 10 second videos or 15 seconds, then that could add up and it could be good. 10 gigabytes of storage, if you hit that storage, well, just delete and clean it up. Premium templates, in my check, when I check this deal out, there's no difference from the free and the premium templates. I'm guessing that that's something for the future, that once they bring in premium templates, well, those are gonna be locked for the free users and it's gonna be available for the lifetime deal buyers. Free icon search, free photo search, and priority support. That's what you get with the lifetime deal. So let's go back into this. Let me start off with a new template, okay? So these are the options that we have available: create a new template or refresh. Let's create a new template. Let's call it test for video. Oh, it's a type, there we go. The size, these are the sizes that we have. It's custom size. You generate such pixels by X pixels, okay? Or you can just select Instagram post, Instagram story, Facebook post, or Facebook story. So let's choose Facebook post. Let's choose from a template. And these are the templates that are available. So online event seminar, simple half image, whatever. Let's choose something that looks good. Let's choose this one right here. Okay, here we go. It just generated. Let me update the title and I'm gonna say test for video. Okay, that's gonna be my new title. And these are the elements that were loaded from the template. I like templates because they make life easier and just it's easier to get started. Now, each one of these elements, it's tied to the editable options. Plus, it's tied to the element that we can edit or not. So if I click on this logo, I can enable it to be editable or not. The editable means that we can edit it via variable. So if we say it's gonna be replaced with something else, we enable it. But if we want it to be, if that's going to be the logo for this, like let's just say that's my brand logo and that's not going to be updated with the client's logo, friends, or whatever, you can turn it off, for example. Okay, we got this text. Do you want that to be updatable or not? We can say yes or no. The name, editable, the person, we can edit that or not edit it. And we can just change all this stuff, editable image and all that. If we want to add more elements, well, we have shapes, images, and we have text, kind of basic text. Any text that we add, so I just added this one right here. Let me go into options. There we go. I'm going to title this testing text. Okay. And here's the options for it. The position, the text, the underline, bold, the family font, the size, height, transform, the color, borders. You have all these options available. Effects for it. For example, shadow, all that options. And it's tied to the element. We can say yes or no to make it editable or not via variable. And it's also here in the elements. All of them are here. Here's the testing for text. I can keep it editable or not, okay? So the next thing we have is photo and icons. We can search through these and use them if we like. So for example, if I wanna use a dog, well, I search for dog. That didn't work. Icon, photo. No, let's search for something else. Let's see, I don't know, sad. Searching for happy, let's sad. Okay, so there's a bug there that's not updating. So they need to fix that. And here's the video. If we want to add video, we can add it there. Remember, the video limit is 30 minutes per month and my files that I've uploaded. So if you're uploading your own images, your logos, those are all going to be there. Now, what are the options to use these variables? Well, once we click on fill and generate images, we have all these options available, which I think it's pretty good. You have via API, so any automation system that supports API, it's gonna work with this. It doesn't matter what you're going to use, just if it's API, you can use it. So if you have Padlet Connect, if you have Integrately, Zapier, and all those have API, or your own system with API, well, you're able to do this and generate custom images with it. You have the form, generate and fill with form. So for example, if I select this, it's going to open up a form. So this is item one. This is my first form. So I have the image. I can use a URL, upload, or select from photos. So if I select this person, it's gonna update it because it's a background. The text one, it says how to be more productive, which is this one right there. If I don't know. Successful. I want to be more successful. Okay, let's do that. And the testing heading text, which is right smack in the middle. This is just test for video, I'm just gonna say. And if I want to add a secondary image, third one, or whatever, I add more items and I fill them out. This is done manually via form. I can also import from a spreadsheet if I like. I just choose the CSV and import a bunch of spreadsheet rows, and it'll make all the images for those rows. So let's just say that's what I like. Let's go ahead and download it. Do I want to download PNG or JPEG? I'll choose JPEG for this, JPG. Let's wait for that to load. There we go, let's download it. Let's open it. And there we go, it's been updated. Test for video, how to be more successful. The original one says productive. That's just for testing purposes. And test for video, that's also updated instead of saying heading text. Now anything that you add, so if I wanted to make the logo change via variable, well, I just activate it and it's gonna allow me to do it. That's one of the ways. Let's go back. Whoops, let's open, I'll create this one now. Let's go into edit this one. This is a little bit more clear on the type of elements. There's several elements in this. So again, fill and generate. Now we have form, share. So again, if we want to share the form via URL, it's going to be fillable. The other one that we chose, it's a form that, but we have to be logged in and we're the one using it. Via URL, that means that inside of the URL, these variables are going to be inside of there and we replace them and it's going to generate it. This is pretty cool to use because if you're using an automation system that's not, if you don't want to go through API, then you just want to replace the variables inside of that link. And integration, it integrates with Zapier and Integromat. I wish they add more integrations. For example, Padlet Connect is getting really popular and I think that's they should add it. But let's go ahead and test out this integration. Okay, so for this, I'm going to use Zapier and I'm going to accept invite for Zap. There we go, let's create a new Zap just to show you what is possible with the automation. And in this case, we'll add a webhook. Okay, there we go. I'm not going to set it up, but if you have webhook, you can catch information from a bunch of places, just anywhere you want. from any form that you have, like flip forms. Wow, I just missed those names, but there's a bunch of forms out there, okay? You can grab that information and fill out the variables so it generates the image. So let's go ahead and continue for this. I am not going to set it up. This is just for testing purposes because we're gonna go into the Dupli setup. I'm going to skip test and there we go, continue. There we go, and we're going to set up Dupli. There we go, choose an event. We have two options here. We can generate an image or we can find and replace. So in this case, we are going to generate an image. Let's go ahead and continue. We are going to connect to a new Dupli account. There we go. I'm going to need the account API and the secret key from Dupli. So let's grab that, okay? So let's go into account settings, API, and we're going to need the API key. Fill that in, the secret key. Let's fill that in, continue. There we go. Back into, where we go, here's my Zapli, Zapier. Okay, it's now connected. Let's go ahead and continue. And it's going to find the variable images that we have available. So in this case, let's choose the template. So there's two templates here, the test video that I made for you guys and the other one I've created. So I'm gonna choose the untitled one and we're gonna call it request name. I'll just say test for video. The format that we want to download this, JPG, and the data to fill out. This data right here is brought from the image that we created. So if you have more elements, they're gonna be available here. If they are not editable elements, they won't be here. So in this case, the element for this, let me open up the template. Let's close this. There's these elements right there, okay? And these elements are the same ones from over here. So topic on how, this is just an example data. And we're gonna see that topic on how. So if I want to replace that every single time, I would choose a variable from any automation I have before this in Zapier. So in this case, we have the webhook, but since I didn't capture any data, we're not gonna be able to view it. So in this case, I'll just fill it out. So I'll just say, we'll keep it like that. Topic, this one is a speaker name. So in this case, I'll put my name, Jorge Aguilar. And the role of that person, CEO, the date, we'll say 22 December, November 2022, okay? And the link, we'll say it's my link, saasmaster.net, and let's go ahead and continue. Now, in this case, I filled it out manually, but the idea is that you grab all this information from variables and automation, and every time it's gonna generate that image automatically. That's the idea, not what I'm doing here, okay? So let's go ahead and test and review. There we go, the image has been generated. So this was the link provided. Again, whatever you do with that link after this automation, well, it's up to you because basically you could do so many things. Let's go ahead and open up this image. There we go. So I updated this. It says topic, my name, CEO, 22 November 2022, and SaaSmaster.net. I didn't have this variable enabled, and you're going to see this. Okay. So let me choose it. There we go. It's that one. See how it wasn't editable? That's why we don't see it on Zapier. So that's why I couldn't replace it. But you get the idea that anything that you have editable, we're able to replace it. And like I mentioned before, if this webhook was connected to a Google Sheet, I don't know, another form, another software, maybe a sign up form from your website, it's gonna generate that image. And when you generate that image, it's gonna make it customized, all right? And this image link, you can use it to send out an email automation email to your people, an email campaign, and it's gonna have their image with their name, with their website, with their own logo, and it's gonna look really cool because it looks customized. It's gonna make people feel that you took the time to make this manually when you're actually using something that's automated. That's the idea behind all of this. So the idea is to create templates. That's gonna be the most time consuming part about it. then automate it, and you're good to go. There's nothing else to do. Just start using your automation like you always would, and it's gonna do everything automatically using the automation services, using API, using the form, using Zapier, Integromat, or whatever type of automation you want to use. But that's the deal with Dupli. At the end of the day, I think I like Dupli because it's easy to use. It's not complex. Everything is just so simple. It's like you generate it, you have the variables. There's not a lot of steps like I've seen on other similar deals to this one, where there's a bunch of steps and the settings are all over the place. Here, I think it's simple. Generate the template, make it editable, go share it to use API, Zapier, or form, and you're good to go. It's ready to use. So that's what I like about Dupli. Well, there you go. That is the Dupli deal. Like I mentioned before, it's $79 for the lifetime deal. So that means that these generate every single month and you can use this forever without paying month to month. So if you guys want to grab it, that link will be in the description. And like I mentioned before, it's an affiliate link. So if you buy through that link, it helps me out with a small commission, which helps me out to make these videos for you guys. Well, I thank y'all for watching. My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. I'll see you guys later.